Figured we'd watch the intro. It's kind of amusing, actually. I don't know how I missed the intro last time, but still, I guess that was it. That was the intro for what's going on anyway, so I'm gonna be the dog, because I don't know, I want to be the dog. So we don't have any money. I could blast my way through here. I've got a controller installed. If we're lucky. Oh. Well, that's a problem. How do I disconnect a character? A player. Like, the problem is, I don't want to play this with a controller. However, I also do want to be able to afford my upgrades here, so I guess let's quit to main menu. I was hoping that you'd, like, slowly just stockpile gold. I don't see a way of doing that. Okay, so I'm gonna be Baron von Dogface this time around, if only because I can. So I don't see a way of interacting with these things, and there's no way to stock up gold, sadly. Okay, whatever. I guess we'll just live without actually upgrading our upgrades for the time being. I'll send the devs a tweet. Actually, you know what? I'm gonna go do that now. Can I bring you guys along? There we go. Okay. Let's see. Tweet deck. I'm just gonna let you guys help me file a Twitter bug reporty looking thing. Okay, it's probably RJE. Maybe? Or how about T-Rascal? Because I believe it's T-Rascal and RJE that are the specific devs that I follow. There's one more guy, but I forget his name. Yep, Craig Sharp, co-founder, artist. Yeah, he's the guy that does all the pixel art. He actually taught himself vector stuff, so he could do the, like, the promo art for this. Okay. Anyway, let's do... let's see, what's the keyboard, Can't upgrade my Okay, there we go. Let's see if he has a response for us by the end of the episode. Anyway, let's go to the city. I'd like to go back to the mansion. But for the time being this will be okay. Okay, so it looks like we've got explosive rats yet again. I probably should have actually grabbed all of those, like, temporary-looking upgrades along the way, but I guess they'll still be fine. It's interesting, actually. Enemy similarities. Visually, they're different, but they still might have something different. Oh, interesting. So this is, like, one long route. It'd actually be interesting if every level actually had, like, a completely different, hand cannon has strike through. It'd be interesting if every level setup actually had a different, gimmick to it. Like, I'm thinking, it'd be really cool to have a level that really is just kind of a line shooter. Let's grab the spread shot. Spread shot's pretty useful. I don't know, the hand cannon's feeling pretty good here. Yeah, because the last guy that split up into tiny little critters after... Okay, this is 110% spread shot territory. I can only... Ow. Oh, they teleport behind you. Good to know. Oh, that's what dodge is for, I guess. And destroy everything, and there's some tea to get me back up. Looks like we got another crit or two. Let's grab burst rifle instead of that. Go back up to full. I don't actually... No, burst rifle is worse than the hand cannon. Hand cannons shoot slowly, but it's got strike through on top of everything else, does it? I was really hoping the hand cannon would be similar to the what is it? Whatever burst cannon it is in Nuclear Throne, the one that fires the giant shotgun pellet and totally destroys everything. Here, we want to stay away from Captain Lasers, and we're gonna have a ghost showing up behind us in like 2 seconds. There we go. Yeah, so I might not be able to currently upgrade my stuff, and I really wish you could actually stockpile gold for future upgrades. And I'm a little bit disappointed you can't do it, but maybe that would make it too easy to stockpile money in general. We'll figure it out, one way or another. Ooh. So there's a grenade launcher again, and another spread shot. Let's switch the, Let's go spread shot grenade launcher. The grenade launcher would have probably been kind of handy against the, would have been kind of handy against Tootin' Crabbin' back there. But I don't know. One way or another, I'm just gonna throw lob grenades into the mix. Okay, there we go. Problem is the gun does overheat just a little bit, but that's okay. I want to get more grenade launcher upgrades. I actually really wish that you could choose what starting weapon you had too. Kind of thinking of Neon Chrome. That had kind of a nice setup in terms of certain things. Okay. I wonder if these wolf guys are as durable. I think they're a little bit less durable than their desert counterparts, but it could be wrong. I did not exactly look very hard. Or test very hard either. But yeah, no, playing this now, I'm definitely feeling the, ow. Okay, a little bit less ow than I thought it was going to be. I'm gonna just keep my distance and lob grenades. Seems like the wisest of choices anyway. But it definitely does feel like playing this right now. This is going to be way more fun when I actually have friends to play with. Not that it's bad, it's just that, you know, it's one of those where after a while, ooh, speed up, useful. After a while, you know, just the homogeny of stuff gets to me. It doesn't feel as specifically designed as Nuclear Throne ever did. And maybe that's just because Nuclear Throne had, like, years of development into it. And, I mean, so does this one, I will admit. But this one has had less time to develop. Like, actually, no, this does remind me of, like, earlier levels on Nuclear Throne. Like, kind of proto-throne? I don't know what you want to call it, but back before they really had everything down. You know, kind of a lot of big open spaces and just kind of chunks stitched together. And I kind of wish it used a mix and match of pre-generated chunks and, like a mix and match of pre-generated chunks, gungeon style, as well as like Nuclear Throne style room segments. Because I think the combination of the two could actually be rather fun. There'd be a lot of werewolves. And this gun's already out. But that's okay. I super dig the fact that this game doesn't have a reload, a force reload or ammo mechanic. The overheat system makes plenty of sense, though. You don't want to give people the, like, stupid powerful gun right from the get-go and just let them do whatever they want with it. They gotta manage that stuff, otherwise it'd just be, broken and dumb. And pure nonsense. Oh wow, these ghosty bits are not exactly what I call the most durable. Useful. Let's see. We want to stay away from Captain Laserpants. I'm definitely getting a little bit more adept at this. I was hoping I could find a treasure chest or two while I was here. Yeah. Oh, that's a bad. Never mind. That's less bad. I think I got hit there. Hard to tell. I keep clicking out of the window. Not often, but it does happen. Usually when I'm trying to shoot at something from, like, a fair ways away. And it's messing me up. Oh, by the way, I forgot to mention, this game doesn't come out until the 16th of August. So if you're watching this well after the fact, well, that means nothing to you, and don't worry about it. But if you're watching this day it comes out, middle of next week. Or something like that, I don't know. I'm probably gonna put out a couple of, I guess I'll just put up one, maybe two episodes of this, and then hopefully just switch straight into multiplayer, because honestly, like, it doesn't have quite the depth that I'd be looking for in a single-player roguelike, but it definitely has the depth I'm looking for in a multiplayer, like, romp type of game, you know, a couple of levels, played every, like, week or two, kind of depending. Okay, so we still gotta find one more super slime beast here. But that's probably okay. I like how those little guys have top hats, just like the ragamuffin-y dude that they spawn from. It's charming. I have not found a single treasure chest while I'm in here. That's kind of sad. Luckily, we've got the grenade launcher, and the grenade launcher is so boss. I like the fact that you can actually see the grenades kind of go up and down as though it's bouncing. That's a neat effect. Wish there was a shadow fort or something. But I guess this is kind of one of those, like, faux side-scrolly top-down, not top-down situations. That's okay. I'm also getting definitely a little bit more used to the... the camera. I still would prefer if the characters were either centered or your cursor was what moves the camera around. But I guess I can kind of live with what it currently is. I do wish that there was at least a treasure chest per floor, just because, I mean, loot pickups are kind of the spice of life. Loot pickups are the reason why I play games. Damn it. Like, yeah, I could totally just, like, default my way through a game if I really wanted to. Where's the fun in that? I also don't know if there's a good reason for me to come down this direction. But at the same time, for the sake of curiosity and, greed, I figured we'd do it. I'm also trying to blitz through this a little bit. Well, no, I'm not trying to blitz through this fast at all. I just... Oh, there's not a treasure chest. It's a lamp. I'm a little bit disappointed. Doesn't look like there's an easy way for me to get to the other side. Is there a reason to, though? There's a ton of rats over there. A couple of ghosts. A lot of ghosts. I missed a lot of things coming through here. I got $2,000, though. So I guess I'll just take it. No upgrades. Do we want a stake launcher? Yeah, let's go with the stake launcher instead of spreadshot. Spreadshot's pretty good, but... Stake launcher, grenade launcher is probably going to be a fine combo. Okay, ye old shop, what can we buy from here? Maybe I should have gone spread launcher, whatever. It's nothing but HP except for revolver damage plus. Which we already have. And we're not going to be using. So this is kind of a bust. Okay. Yeah, I wouldn't mind getting some grenade launcher upgrades at some point along the way, just because of how effective they are. Oh yeah, some people might be wondering, do the characters have any different characteristics to them? They don't. That was another question I asked. I don't remember what other ones they were. I don't know. Actually, I will admit, as weird as this sounds, talking to... It was T-Rascal that was specifically talking to all as a PAX and met them and stuff. But, that's actually one of my fonder memories from, PAX East this year. It was just such a pleasant conversation, I think. Oh, no. Getting surrounded is bad, especially because enemies will, like, knock you around pretty easily. Gonna need some tea. I'm killing myself slowly here, which is bad. Oh, there's a difference between the zombies and the werewolves. It's a bad time. Oh. Well, I'm glad we got pushed all the way back up here, because there's a treasure chest. Okay, Vulcan's boots, armored waistcoat, and some kind of Ankh thing. I don't remember what it does. I like the power-ups in this game. I wish they were a tad more common. Mainly just because I love power-ups. Like, actually, I like games that scale them up. Let's see. Fire rate, hand cannon. Might not be a bad reason to pick up a hand cannon next time one drops. Currently, I'm still pretty happy with the grenade launcher. But yeah, I don't know. I'd like more items that modify gameplay in some way. Like, I love double shot. I love homing. I love triple shot. I love things that, like, wildly change my attack. Like, it'd be really cool, actually, if you could upgrade, a weapon from, like, one type into another, or, like, some kind of weird, bizarre weapon evolution system. If you could, like, pump money into it in the middle of a run. Like, what's a good example? I guess I'm just thinking of Binding of Isaac, where, you know, if you get Brimstone, suddenly gameplay is different. Okay, let's get the hand cannon. Might as well get the hand cannon upgrade. I think it's only a 5%, but still. Okay. Don't know what I got there. Can't imagine it was particularly great. Ow. Thought it was okay. Guess it wasn't. There's a ton of rats down here. They're all exploding. Or, I'd say like a solid half of them are explosive. But that's not a problem. Because we're doing okay. I'm curious. And I keep forgetting I actually have a dodge here. I said earlier getting surrounded is super dangerous. It's actually not as dangerous as I made it out to be. Wonder what that meant. Like, there's like a ba-da-dig noise. And I have no idea what that could possibly mean. Well, that's okay. I'm gonna just blast my way through everything. I could throw grenades, but they don't quite have the, they don't have quite the, I want to get that T, but no dice. They don't have quite the, recharge rate I'm looking for here. I guess I could just fire a couple of them, more or less build up my, my heat meter, and then switch back over to the hand cannon. Hand cannon is actually doing a fair amount of work here. I was just going with the grenade launcher because it seemed punchy. I wish these guys, their knife toss was a little bit more directed. Because this guy is literally only dangerous from the side and when you kill him. Which is a little interesting. Oh, glad I came back here. There we go. Turns out there's another chest. What's it got for me? Okay, so what's this? Mercury's Blessing. Doesn't tell me. Armored Waistcoat. Doesn't tell me what it is. We have more defense, but we're slower. But that's not necessarily a bad. It kind of varies. Just want to get these guys with the grenade before they even know I'm here. Haha! Yeah, I will admit that the AI in this is not as, I'm not gonna say it's as advanced as like Nuclear Thrones is. It feels like the enemies have the enemies have really short sight radiuses. And so instead, it's, they've just been upped in quantity and a little bit lower in quality. I wouldn't mind a couple of, like, unique-y things along the way that are, like, a little scarier to run into, just out of, like, sheer, I don't know. Probably should have dodged there, and there's nothing down this direction. Okay, that's fine. Was that a chest along the way there? The answer is no. Music gets a little repetitive. I think this is definitely going to be more of a multiplayer rompy type game. Not to just besmirch, but honestly, that's what the game was designed for. I really need to run away from those guys faster. Because currently, I don't, and it's a problem. Okay. Could die here. Yeah, pissing off too many of these ghosts means we run into issues. Okay. Well, I think we'll be fine. Just go around corners, hope for the best, blast things. Yeah, we've got these rats here. I guess let's go this way for a second. I don't know if this way is better or worse or anything. I just figured, let's try it. And we'll be okay. That's the wrong button for switching weapon types. Okay, there we go. Can I use... No, you can't use mouse wheel to switch either. Good to know. Yeah, so these ghosts do dodge attacks. I could use some tea. Right about now. Well, we've still got a fair amount of HP. There's no chest in here? There's no chest in here. And barrels and boxes do not frequently have exactly what I'm looking for, which is a problem. Okay. Wow, I'm so close to death. I'll just keep pushing it. Again, the extra life system is kind of handy. Ideally, I'd like to save them for the boss fight. Or maybe it's just me. Yeah, we need to use the grenade launcher. It insta-kills these ghosts. Whereas the hand cannon takes a couple of hits. And I'd rather kind of awkwardly fire the grenade launcher than anything else. Oh, I love the fact that they're explosive enemies. Oop. Stay away from that. We got werewolves aplenty. But this thing's doing mad work. Okay. I'll set up there. You know what? This game really does remind me of Hive Jump, too. Which is another roguelike. I mean, obviously, like, the gameplay is completely different, but the mindset is very similar. You know, retro pixely style, made to be played largely with friends, a power-up system, permanent upgrades, so on and so forth. I mean, if you boil it down, all games are the same, but they do end up, I think, sharing a pretty similar... Oh, I'm dead. I totally forgot about the, oh. Interesting that it would do that. I totally forgot about the little goons that come out. Oh, there's the next zombieast. If I can take out the laser dudes, we're okay. Let's see, so the hand cannon is mostly as a, the hand cannon is a good stop over here. Okay, come on. Just out of my way for a bit. Oh, and the ghost. Ghost's a problem. We've got a little bit more. The one thing I don't like about this kind of objective system is it's kind of indistinct. Like, I'd actually rather deal with, like, a bunch of smaller levels or something with the boss at the end than, like, a sub-objective that you gotta get done. But maybe that's just me, even though, like, ultimately it doesn't really matter. Like, I'm still gonna have to fight X to get through. The only concern is if I somehow don't manage to, to find the last zombieast as I'm adventuring here. But I think I'll be okay. Okay. Okay, there's two down. There's the rest. Okay, we're good. And we found the portal out. No zombieast, though. Also, I think I will go with the blunderbuss. It's a bit on the short range, but I can use grenades against the boss, and yeah, this seems like a better idea. Because yeah, this way I actually have something reliable. Because I like my grenades, but they run out of juice a little bit fast. Or it overheats quickly. And also, it does have this bad tendency of, oh, please tell me the last zombieast is over here. We'll figure it out. Wow. Blunderbuss is nuts. Probably should be a little bit more careful against those guys. But that's okay. Do we have a zombieast? We have the zombieast. Okay, cool. Yeah, because I will admit, I'm under a bit of a time limit here. And, I was like, I can just fit in one more. Holy fuck, that hurt. Note to self, zombies don't mess around. Well, we're going into a boss. We're going into the boss fight next, and I think we'll be okay. As long as I don't get poisoned here. We've got one more life, and there's a little bit of tea. Okay, we're good. Boss, Dusty Batkins. I think I'm gonna hit him with grenades. I'll use the, blunderbuss on the bats. Actually, I might be more okay than I give it credit for with the blunderbuss. I don't know. We might also just die. Who knows? Oh, this is a bad time to move the camera, game. Like, I'd rather have an icon indicating where he is, to some degree. Okay. Yeah, we'll go grenade launcher on this one. Yeah, because now I can't tell what's going on with those enemies. Who are arguably just as dangerous as the bosses, if not more so. Because the boss has very telegraphed attacks that are kind of easy to tell who, when, where, and I've got the wrong gun. Hand cannon might have been a good idea, stake launcher would have been okay. But yeah, the blunderbuss just does not have the oomph we're looking for. We might still be able to defeat Dusty Batkins. One life remaining, however, we got a stake launcher. Alright. Suddenly, possibility is open for us. Now I have a weapon that more or less has infinite ammo, strike through, and range. Which we did not have earlier, I should have left that T. Well, that's okay. Oh. Hell. Okay, so he's got mirror images. Good to know. Okay, I'm gonna be honest, this is a lot harder than Mr. Krabs' Wild Ride. Oh, we get a little bit more armor. I think they stack. I hope they stack. I want to believe they stack. This is kind of nuts. At least the bats have kind of a short-term memory. There we go. Yeah, we got this. We got really lucky with that. We got really lucky with that freaking, stake launcher bat drop. If it weren't for that, we'd be dead already. Oh, hey, more armor. Okay, they seem to stack. In retrospect, the movement speed might have been kind of a useful thing. But still. The one thing is, I'm spending all of my time cleaning up bats here, and it's being a bit of a nuisance. I also really wish I could see the cursor. Because, yeah, currently can't see the cursor at all. It is a problem. But that's okay. Oh, we're only at the halfway point. Ugh, this boss is a meat shield. Hopefully phase two is a little bit more interesting. Wait, no, we're already on phase two. Which is, he just splits into parts. Well, we might just die. I don't know. Hard to tell. This would be a lot easier with friends. I wonder if this boss specifically was scaled for that. Hard to tell. I wish killing his bats that he splits up to was almost like a second phase or something. Just because this is rather time consuming. Trying to get through him here. Okay, at least we got some tea from that. However, we are currently dying. Okay, this is cooler though. I'll give this credit where credit's due. This is a much, much more high stakes boss fight. I just want this tea, man. Let me get my tea. I got the thirst that only tea can satisfy. And you ain't providing. Well, he is providing, actually. It's a little weird that we're getting tea while we're out here. There's just like a litter of guns and whatever. Okay, there's a hand cannon in the center. I wouldn't mind picking it up. But things have actively become largely worse since we started this. We're screwed. There's nothing. Alright. Leave game. That was insane. Okay, I'll see you guys in the next episode of Monsters and Monocles. And as always, thanks for watching. Oh yeah, let's go see if he responded. Nope, he didn't. Well, that's fine. Hopefully he'll respond by tomorrow's episode. Oh well. Anyway, like I was saying, see you guys next time. Thanks for watching.